When you are testing food for mycotoxins, you need reliable results to make the right decisions. But have you ever wondered how reliable your analytical results really are? Well, it depends not only on the test system you use. In general, there are three aspects that determine the reliability of an analysis: sample collection, sample preparation, and analysis. And especially when you are testing for mycotoxins, the analysis part actually has the lowest influence. The problem with mycotoxins is that they are extremely heterogeneously distributed in food. They are concentrated in certain spots, so-called hotspots, that contain a lot of mycotoxins, while the rest of the lot may be completely free from mycotoxins. This is particularly the case for mycotoxins that are produced during storage, such as aflatoxin. And the larger the particle size of the food, think of figs or nuts, the more heterogeneous is the distribution. Imagine you have a truckload of grains with a few contaminated kernels here and there. When your sample is not representative, it is likely that you end up underestimating the mycotoxin content, resulting in hazardous food reaching the market. What could also happen is that you overestimate the mycotoxin content, leading to unnecessary rejection of food. So what can you do about it? Implement a sampling plan. Always collect the sample from multiple points of the lot and take enough of it. Sample preparation also has huge influence on the test result, so make sure to grind and homogenize the sample sufficiently. Remember, even the most precise test method will not provide reliable results if the sample is not representative or sample preparation is insufficient. So never save on sampling or sample preparations.